Hey guys, what's up and welcome to another episode on the One of a Kind RX7. As you've probably gathered, I'm actually sitting in the car right now and I've just been driving it through the mountains here in Tochigi. And it is so much fun to drive a turboed rotary. I have to recommend it to you guys. If you ever get the chance, take it up and go for a drive in one. They're a lot of fun. Now just really quickly, where Joshua is in Tochigi, which is where the entire anime for Initial D was designed off. So the actual mountains that they designed and did the drawings and everything for the anime and the manga are from here in Tochigi. So the mountains here to drive around in are absolutely awesome. And some of them are exactly the same as what you saw in the anime for Initial D. Anyways guys, I'm really excited to show you an update on the car, show you where it's at, so let's jump into it right now.
Wherever love goes, there is also misery. It's no mystery. And you and I, we got history, yeah. Wherever love flows, there is also tragedy. When we're in too deep. And you and I, we got history, yeah.
Alright guys, so I'm now in Joshua's garage and I'm going to show you guys around. Look at some customers' cars and what other things he's been working on and any other updates and stuff like that. Okay, so first of all, you'll notice that the layout of his workshop has changed heaps, and that's because he's now got this retro cool-as hoist in here, so he can do a lot more work on cars and stuff like that and do some engine swaps, which will be sweet. Right now, he's working on a Mark V Toyota, which he's doing like just the usual kind of fenders and stuff like that, these custom side fenders, and this epic custom bonnet with these three vents in each side. So that's where you like cut, bring it down, and then he's welded in these corner triangle pieces and stuff. He's just done a quick coat on this just to undercoat to show what it's going to look like, and he's going to try and finish this all up today, which is awesome. He's also working on the rear bar, some other little trimmings and stuff, eyelids for the headlights. I'll show you eyelids for the headlights and other trimmings, plus side skirts for the car as well, which is awesome. And let's go out and have a look at what other cars he's got. Oh, you got a delivery, bro?
Lights.
Lights? Yeah. Awesome. I think this is another Mark X. I'm not entirely sure. Yeah, another Mark X that he's working on. This thing's gonna get completely overhauled and changed. What about the rims, bro? New rims on this?
No.
No?
Because I don't get too much money.
Oh, okay. I hate those rims, chromies. The Aldi's still here and kicking. The old Chevy truck's still here and kicking. This GTR is still here and kicking. Really sad story on this, man. Like, really sad story. Let me show you. Look at this. And it just goes throughout the entire car. It literally looks like this thing was just sitting in like floodwaters and rusting away. And it sucks when you see an R32 GTR Skyline just rusted up and stuffed like this. This is so sad. And what it sucks even more is the customer of this car, he's an American guy, and some Japanese person completely ripped him off, and he didn't know that it was all rusted and stuffed up, and he paid quite a lot of money for this. And unfortunately, it's a rust bucket and needs a lot of work. Really, it needs a shell swap. Anyways, there's this badass Celsior here as well. And that's got these awesome custom fenders on it, which Joshua did as well last time, and they look freaking amazing. You saw that in one of the other videos. I love these tail lights on it. It looks sick as hell. And there's another Celsior here, and this one's getting heaps more work done to it as well, custom body kit and stuff. Don't think this front bar's for it, because that's for the 350Z, the Nismo 350Z, which is here, which has a complete VS kit on it, which is a Vel slide. Not entirely sure how to pronounce that correctly. Anyways, this is getting completely overhauled. He's gonna do a crazy body kit, wide body kit on this as well. We'll take that for a drive through the mountains later on today as well, and we'll do a shoot for that. And then, of course, guys, the one of a kind RX7. So you can see he's done a few black trimmings and stuff on the front here, and he's got a nice grill in the front. He's bottomed out once by the looks of it here and just chipped it. Which is just normal. You can fix that, no problem. Wheels still black, and Heaps Edition looks sweet. And overall, the car looks good. Now, Joshua, yeah, check out the rear bar. He's changed the rear bar too, guys. Look at that. Looks sick as hell. And yeah, he's put this wing on for now.
just so he's got some kind of wang on there. But yeah, guys, so I was talking to Joshua and he's not happy with the paint. He is going to be changing the entire color of the car again. This isn't the final paint job, so don't stress. He's probably going to do like a red or a black, or maybe both of those together. Right now we've got the bonnet up because there's a little bit of an issue with a sensor of some kind. The car like bogs down at 3,500 RPM, and hopefully we can get that fixed today and diagnose what the issue is there. I'll be Googling away at that because rotaries are not my forte. My forte are Nissans and RBs, so I'll stick to those. But it is so much fun to drive when it's boosting properly and there are no breakdown issues. Anyways, we're gonna get to work, get some work done. Damn, I love these fenders. They're so good. Hard to believe, hey, like when you look at this, it looks so good. You can't even tell that that was fiberglassed and bogged and puttied up. Man, I love it. Anyways, Tochigi guys, Tochigi, represent. I don't see if I can get in here and show you guys these crazy spaces. I don't know if you can see those spaces, but they are like 70, 80 mil long spaces. So crazy. Anyways, guys, I'm gonna get in there. I'm gonna start helping Joshua out and I'll film some stuff that we're doing and then I'll go for a drive later in the 350Z. These tail lights for an 86 look sweet. Where are these 86 tail lights going? In the front of this. What? So he wants these tail lights
here.
In the rear here. He wants 86 tail lights in the rear of this.
Yes. I love them more.
I hope he has a lot of money.
Front is gonna be strange because they want it. Front light. Front bumper.
What lights do they want in the front bumper, bro?
Yeah.
They want that in the front?
No, this is America's light. This is the normal light. They want this.
Oh, that's another 86 front light.
Yes. Right. In the front bumper.
So, are they keeping these?
Yes.
They're putting this in. So they're doing double lights.
Yes.
So they're doing double lights on this. They're putting those crazy Mark X lights in there with all those other ones. So this is getting swapped. And then they want that in the bumper as well?
Yes.
Is that the craziest thing you've ever had someone ask you to do? Well, I mean, if he's paying you, who cares, right? A customer gets what he wants. That's insane.
I don't want he use my shop name.
Yeah, you didn't do it, right?
Crazy.
Let's have a look at these other Mark X lights real quick. What the hell, dude?
Kakui,
ne? And like that would all light up too. Dude, that's insane.
Nice, it's nice.
And yet the car, the inside of the car looks like it's for a chick. Looks like a girl's car.
This car owner is Peruvian.
He's Peruvian?
Yes.
Oh, it makes sense, the chromy rims. Do you think his style of car modifications suit the Peruvian lifestyle?
Peruvian sense is not good.
Peruvian sense is not good?
Not good.
But aren't you Peruvian? Does that mean that your sense isn't good?
I mix Spain and German and Israel.
You're mixed?
Yeah, I mix.
You're mixed?
Yeah, I mix. German, Israel and Spain. So I a little different.
Has he got you fixing this as well? Are you doing fenders on this?
This is one point. He don't want to fix that because he has no money for that.
But he has money to put double headlights in the front.
He had money to put double headlights, to change the front design, the side design, the rear design.
Those light bulbs falling out.
We'll be right back.
man, these Zeds are so nice, these fair ladies to drive. Beautiful. Man, it's so easy to do over 150 of this. Here it is, guys. Side skirts are now on the car. Looking mint. Man, I love these over fenders. They look so good. Front bars on, looking nice. Other side skirts are on. Car just needs a bit more polishing done. Cleaning up. And then the rear bar's going on too now. So Joshua's made all these little pieces to go on each piece that matches the over fenders he made. This thing's gonna look so sick. Skoda, you were here working while I was out playing. And I drove his FD for a little bit and I chipped his front bar, unfortunately.
Thank you very much for giving me more work.
More work? Go, man. Demo, luckily it's an easy fix, not a big crack or anything. I think that happened when I went through the roadworks. No road, so it's all bumpy. So what colors are you thinking of painting it, bro?
Red and black.
Red and black? Nice. You gonna change the body kit anymore? Are you gonna add some more like aero pieces? Like those black
pieces? Like this line?
Yep.
One more here.
One more there? In there. Look good.
It's all?
A lot of people have been saying on the comments that it looks like an Austin Martin Vulcan. The Vulcan, yes. Austin Martin.
Yes.
Yeah. That's where he got inspired from to make it.
So the next, gonna be my origin.
Yeah. Now, you were saying that you got an Aristo 2JZ coming.
Yeah.
It's gonna be your drift car, right?
Maybe. I wanna try don't crash.
You wanna try to don't crash? Okay, we'll have to go to Minami and practice out there.
Yeah, sure.
Nah. Street drifting, the risk is fairly high. A lot more obstacles in the way and there's not much room. So we'll go out to Minami Circuit and do a drift practice day.
When you're gonna buy your drift car?
Hopefully January, February. Really soon, after Christmas. Yeah. Well, my drift car here in Japan at least. This one's gonna look sick, man. This is what you're building, right? Making this seems. Oh, we're going for an adventure around the side. Oh, wow. That looks awesome, dude.
Little.
Jeez, I love this detail you got here for the. Yeah, that's gonna look good, man.
And this is the front.
And then that's the front bar. And then you're gonna add like another lip again behind under it.
In there.
And this is where like all your old parts and stuff are. Lots of fiberglass parts. Spare parts. Just found that Mazda badge on the ground, so I threw it on. So this is what the one-of-a-kind RX-7 currently looks like before it gets resprayed all over again. Red and black, and a few more changes here and there to the front bar. But otherwise, this is the final product. Are you gonna put a different wing on the back? You're gonna make a custom wing, right? Yeah. So that's it for now. So a little bit of history on this car is this came all the way from Goto, Fukue Goto, which is the island where Koshikubi-san, Koshikubi Engineering is. So this used to be his car And then he got the GTR, which is his main project car, and he wanted to sell this, and Joshua bought it off him. So this came all the way from an island by ferry, 3 hours off the mainland of Nagasaki. So it takes 3 hours to get there by boat, and Joshua flew down there, and then he... 500, and then you drove 500 kilometers all the way up here, 1,000. Right?
1,000.
So once he picked it up and put the car on the ferry, but you had problems. The alternator died before you could get to the ferry, so you had to go back, get a new alternator, fix it. And then from there, then he finally the next day got on the ferry and then drove over 1,000 kilometers all the way back up here.
With the back brakes in bad condition.
Oh, that's right. The rear brake piston was seized. So he just drove it with front brakes. And what's crazy though is the odometer on this only reads 17,000 kilometers. So it's actually done low, like really, really low mileage. Really good score. And he only paid like about probably like $14,000 Australian for it. So he did really well. And then add on all the other cars that he has here, his FD, his Audi, and his truck. He's got enough cars, it's crazy. You gonna sell them, bro?
No.
You gonna keep them all?
Yeah.
You got plans for them all?
I wanna make, when I be rich, I'm gonna make my own collection.
Ine. Okay, Joshua, I'm gonna read out some YouTube comments to you, and I want you to just reply to them for me. So someone said, this looks a lot like an Austin Vulcan.
Yeah.
It's supposed to, right?
Yes.
Yeah. So would you say like the Austin Vulcan inspired you to make that body kit?
Uh-huh.
Yeah, cool. Okay. Some people call it the Austin Mazda RX Vulcan.
Wow, nice, nice name.
Austin Mazda RX Vulcan.
We're nice.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
I gotta make a sticker.
Yeah, you can make a sticker for that. All right, Ine. The front looks like a Pokemon.
Why?
The front looks like a Pokemon. That's what one person said. Like a fish or something, right?
Yeah,
like,
right? I think it... This front looks like a catfish. Catfish, Japanese fish. You've never heard?
Catfish. Yeah, yeah, catfish. Oh, yeah. One person wants to know, what kind of paint did you use?
My own paint. I made the paint with white and put a little bit of black.
Yeah, so you mixed your own paint?
Yes.
Great.
It's original.
Awesome. The front looks like a catfish with its mouth open. There you go, that's what you were saying. What kind of wheels are those?
I don't know the maker.
You don't know the maker?
I don't know the maker.
You reversed them though, right? You reversed it so that the rear ones, so
it's
they were deep dish?
It's other wheels.
Other way?
I have other wheels in the garage.
Are you guys gonna put bags on it or something? Because it's low, it's very low. I mean, if you rolled into a car meet with that, I would right away assume you have a Stance Nation shirt on. Are you a Stance Nation boy?
No.
No? You just like your car low, right?
Yes.
Yeah. Bags would be good though, right? So you could bring it up a little bit more while driving it. Okay, here we go. This is a pretty negative one.
What?
Oh my God, can somebody help this tortured RX-7? A nice looking car got transformed into an ugly fiberglass plastic monster.
Oh, thank you, man.
And then this is what someone said after his comment. I think if this guy gave a F about the hate comments, he wouldn't have posted it on YouTube.
I don't care about negative comments.
That's right, because it's not their car.
Yes.
Right?
And I know they can't make nothing.
And lots of these people don't understand that that's what Japanese culture is like.
Uh-huh.
You make something for yourself because you like it.
Yes.
You don't make it to please other people. You don't care what other people think.
Yes.
Exactly.
That is the point.
Yes. All right, guys, that's it. That's my time. Thanks heaps for watching. Make sure you like, comment, share, and subscribe. As for the FD, that's nothing really is going to be happening on that until Joshua finishes all the work with his customers' cards. He's a mad dude. And once he's finished with all these customers' cars and gets paid for that, then he'll have the time and the money to work on his own car and do more modifications and cool stuff like that. So until then, ja matane. just subscribe or a kitten will die. No, I won't murder a kitten, that's terrible. I don't even know why I said that.